You're listening to Turi Writers' She Said What podcast. I'm Turi, along with Marcy Persky. In this installment, a creative solution to the family snoring problem, which involves the risk of death. Also, rat hunting dogs, and why we should support smarter porn stars. Can you hear the cicadas outside my window?
No.
Oh, they're so loud.
I'm so glad we don't have them.
Really?
I hate their guts. I hate anything that has, like...
guts?
No, fur. Anything that's hairless.
Huh. But you have fish.
Oh, I love them. But who knows if they have hair?
You don't pet them. Oh, my God. Speaking of hair, one of my social media radio friends sent some picture of some rapper who hangs chains off his head, little chains instead of hair, from surgically implanted hooks, or so he says. And then she posts this thing that she writes comments, and I'm thinking, where do you start? How many times have you had your hair blow into your face? Now imagine that it's a metal chain blowing into your face. How many times have you caught your hair in something, like, you know, the car window going up? Or now imagine that your skull can get a big, like, hole pulled out of the scalp from that. All the times you've got a hair, like, in your, you're eating an ice cream cone and a little hair gets in there. Now imagine that your teeth break.
Yeah, but I bet every tooth that this rapper has diamonds embedded in it.
Oh, you know what? You may have a point there.
Think about eating corn on the cob with diamonds embedded in your teeth.
My body modification is getting old. That's my body modification.
Yeah. There you go.
It's like these breasts. They're not where they used to be.
Oh, mine are right where they belong in my lap so I don't fall off the chair.
Feeling comfortable. It's just where you can reach down and pet them just like a kitten.
Don't you want a kitten?
Not if it looks like your breasts. No. And I also don't want a kitten while we're on the subject. Don't want any of that.
I had an adventure last night.
Oh?
So, as you know, we are the opposite of you. We're on ranch time here.
Yes.
So we go to bed like 9:30, sometimes even earlier. But Frankie's up at 4:30, and I'm usually up by 6. Ugh. And yeah, I know it makes you want to cry, but
no.
Last night, I don't know what I was watching, something really stupid, but it was important enough that I said to Frankie, "You go to bed, I'll be there in a minute." And I get in bed and I'm all comfortable. He starts snoring. And I don't mean like snoring quietly. I mean like there was a freight train next to my head. And I thought about it for a while and I said, well, maybe I can sleep with this. So an hour later, I said, okay, I can't sleep with this. And I grabbed my pillow and my little blanket and slept out into the living room. Laid down on the couch, and 2 minutes later, a leather alarm starts going off on his phone. Oh, and it was like, right next to my head. But I figured out how to at least open it to see what was so important. And it's a flash flood warning nowhere near us. And so I thought, well, it'll stop. Every 15 minutes for the next hour and a half, because I turned on the TV to try and drown it out. And I finally wound up back in my bed with earplugs.
Wow. You just lived a game of would you rather. You know that game. Would you rather clean up dog vomit or eat a cereal bowl of chocolate covered ants? That game.
That's right.
As a person who snores, I do feel sympathy for Frankie. On a vacation in Italy, I was heard snoring 3 flights down from where I was snoring. So it's pretty bad.
That's a talent. When it's that loud, it's a talent. I read an article that said that you could duct tape someone's mouth shut and it wouldn't hurt them.
that the article you, where did you read this? Like S&M Daily? Where did you read this?
it just showed up on my news feed on my phone.
Had you Googled how to stop someone from snoring?
No.
Is
No,
it
I mean, well, I told you the government listens to every word I say, but
it paid advertising by some law firm, some
no,
criminal defense lawyer wants
it
to?
was an actual medical article about duct taping someone's mouth shut, and as long as they can breathe through their nose,
Ah, that's a biggie.
yeah,
Because
that's a biggie.
frequently people who snore also cannot breathe well through their noses.
But it would teach you to.
Not
It would be like
fast enough, no.
training. Okay, now you can move on.
Not soon enough. You'd be really quiet after. How long does it take to actually die of oxygen deprivation? Like
Suffocation.
3, 4 minutes? Yeah, you're not really suffocating, you're
I'll look
learning.
that up.
You're learning. Huh, what a thought. Just duct tape somebody's mouth.
You can ask Jeeves. I mean,
You like
I.
asking Jeeves. Jeeves is no friend of mine. So stupid things on video. I've had a week of thinking things about news stories where people assume that the reason I think these things is not the reason I think them.
Okay.
And this is not a political show. So again, I have to be very careful because I would say this no matter whose political party she represented. But you've probably followed the story of the woman who was running for the state legislature, which they call something different in Virginia, who, with her husband, likes to make live porn videos online and then agree to perform particular acts for quote, close quote, tips, close quote.
Yes.
Yeah. And someone will, ch it's supposed to be with live chat interaction. So
It's
someone,
OnlyFans, isn't it?
no, it's not. It's so this is a thing where you can perform this act, and then somebody might say, we're just gonna make it G-rated. Somebody might say, I really want you to take her earrings off.
He thinks you know too much about
And
this.
so, well, it's been all over the papers. And
I know.
so she'll say, well, I'll let my husband take my earrings off if you send tips. And the weird part about this is that there are a whole lot of people who are disgusted by the fact that she and her husband make live porno videos, even though they are parents, and that she's performing for tips. And I'm just upset because every parent has had this lecture where they tell their child, anything you put online is going to stay online. Anybody can see it.
Yep.
Yeah. And so, number one, she clearly thought she could run for office and nobody would see this thing, which qualifies her as having a problem with her intelligence. And number two, what has she told her children? Like, has she not told them anything about being wise on the internet? Or does she just not take her own advice? In other words, forget her politics. She is stupid, just a stupid person. And I wouldn't care what party she was in, really. Nobody should serve an elected office who's that stupid, who doesn't know that anything you put online is going to be seen by anybody forever. And nobody who's that stupid should be raising children. And this woman is a nurse. So while I'm at it, I'd like to condemn whatever nursing school let her graduate because clearly she's stupid. I wouldn't let her take my temperature, never mind
Well,
voting on legislation.
without naming names, just because I can't pronounce some of them, but I just Googled and there have been six, quote unquote, adult stars who ran for a public office in the United
All
States.
right, let me stop you right there. If she ran as an adult star, I'd have no problem with this. None. Again, see, you're not understanding. The problem is that she didn't disclose that or run as that, and somehow she thought no one would find out about it. That's the problem. The
Well,
problem
people
isn't that
find
she
out
said,
about everything.
that's right. That's exactly my point. If she'd just said, I am a nurse practitioner and amateur porn star, fine. But the fact that she didn't disclose it, and then somebody, of course, because the internet found out about it,
You can
and
find anything.
right, and of course, even though she took it down from the place where she had posted it, of course it goes everywhere because once it's on the internet, it's everywhere. And the fact
True.
that she's so stupid that she did not even figure out that this could happen. So that is one of my 2 points. And my second point is that clearly, if she has not told her children that anything you do can be found forever on the internet, she's a bad parent. This is why I'm so annoyed. It's not that I give a rat's patootie that she's a porn star. I don't care if she were like, I'm a porn star and I'm running in this party and these are my views. If I agreed with them and it was my party, I'd vote for her. But the problem is that she is stupid.
Stormy Daniels says that she's thinking of running for Senate.
What part of I don't care that she's a porn star are you missing here? Why aren't
I'm
you
just
listening
goading
to me?
you.
You're just
I'm listening. I'm listening, Mom.
ah. Okay. All
I'm
right.
just goading you
You are.
into more fury
It's
because it's
just.
fun.
Speaking of more fury, the car that we've just been sort of nursing along needs a lot more nursing, just suddenly.
Time to trade it in.
I don't trade anything in. I
I love my new car. I love my
see it
new
into
car.
a shallow grave. I just.
I love my new car that I bought a little vacuum cleaner for it.
Aw, like at the
And my
truck stops. Aw.
Frankie's like, "What is this?" And I said, "It's a vacuum cleaner for the new, as of yet unnamed car."
It was it advertised on the internet?
Of course it was.
Ah, okay. All right. Well,
Of
so
course.
the old I get to the point where any car that I own, if I'm gonna sell it, I end up fixing it anyway so that I can sell it running. And if I get the cost of the last repair back, then I figure I'm all right. So
We did that with Duke Perry, and now he belongs to Eve, and he's gone from being parked in the front of the house to being parked in the back of
that
the
is not the
house
same thing at all. No,
with the hood up.
that's not the same thing. With the hood up? Wait, he
Yeah,
stopped
so
running
no
again?
rats.
No.
It's
Oh, so
so
no
no,
rats can go in and eat your
yes, and
wires.
all the hoods are up. They all have little rat alarms too, which is just lovely to think
Do they
about.
go off all night, the rat alarms?
You can't hear them. They're strobe lights.
Oh, do the rats really care?
I guess they do, because people say they work.
Well, I don't know who those people are, but I'm voting for this group of people I read about in the Washington Post. They own terriers, which are a breed of
Oh, I
dog
know.
that are
Oh,
bred.
I couldn't even read
They're
through that.
bred to hunt
I
rats and shake them to death.
wanted to read that so
I was
badly,
so
and
happy
I was
about it.
so mortified and
All right, well,
terrified
let's
by
explain.
these poor dogs with rats hanging out of their
They love
mouths.
it. They're
And
very happy.
I got down to like where the whatever the rat scallions or whatever they
Yeah,
call
that's what they
themselves.
call themselves. Yeah, the
They put
rapscallions.
on rubber gloves and masks and pick the rats up by their tails and throw them in a bag. And I was just like, great. This is what I need to be reading right before I go to bed.
Even if you're not disgusted by the rats, though, your maternal anxiety kicks in because these rat hunting dog owners feel like they've taken all precautions because their dogs are fully vaccinated and because
Yeah.
they have a veterinarian who's also a dog breeder owner with them who can administer to any bites that occur. But they send their dogs down these alleys where there is glass and there are needles and there are broken things and they let them jump around in dumpsters. And I'm thinking, I would put my dog in a hazmat suit if I had my dog. I would put it in little rubber booties. I wouldn't let my dog jump into a dumpster. What kind of.
What do you do when your dog wants to give you a kiss?
Oh, that's the other thing.
Ooh, rat mouth.
One of the owners
Ooh.
said that she doesn't let her dog lick her for several days after a hunt.
Duct tape. That's when you not only duct tape your spouse's mouth, you duct tape the dog's as well. And say, here, you leave a little bit of opening so you can shove kibble. So yeah, we're going through all these good uses for duct tape. I should be writing them down.
Yeah. Assuming you've come this far because you enjoy the podcast, may we recommend my book, She Said What? A Life on the Air. It's available at your neighborhood bookstore or on Amazon. And if you're feeling especially generous, please leave the podcast a good review. Thanks.